5, 4, 3, 2.
And this is Lucy, and welcome to WNBC. Are you having a hard time figuring out fun things to do?
Are you having a hard time figuring out fun things to do? Never fear, Gabby is here to save the day. The following are some activities you may want to try. All right, let's get into it. Okay, hold on. Before we get too far into the video, I need to make sure everybody does the following activities very responsibly. All right, I think that's it. Back to the video.
Ride your bike. Ride a skateboard. Don't know how to ride a skateboard? Me neither. We'll learn together. Do some yoga. Learn a new instrument, maybe. Go on a run. Go on a jog. Or maybe even a speed walk. Read a book. Don't like reading? Write a book. Walk your dog. Walk your cat. Don't have either? Go on another speed walk. Paint a picture. Play a card game. Play a board game. Play whatever you would call this kind of game. Maybe some hide and seek. You could build an epic fort. Create an obstacle course. Build a campfire. Maybe even roast some marshmallows.
And at the end of the day, host a family dance competition. Alright, in all seriousness, there are so many fun activities we can do. We just have to get a little bit creative.
Well, I hope you guys are all staying
safe, happy, and healthy. See you soon, Warriors.
Here's some Chromebook info. Do you know how to use Google Classroom?
Okay, so the first thing you're going to want to do is go on Google and type in Google Classroom. Once you get there, you're going to want to click on classroom.google.com. And if you haven't already, you should have all your classes right here in the front. But if you're not already having all your classes in front of you, you have this little plus button over here that says join class, and right here you can enter in the class code and you can ask your teacher for that code if you're not already in all of your classes. And then right here to the left corner you have three little lines that you can click on. You have your classes, your calendar. The good thing about the calendar is that it kind of gives you an overline of the whole week, and you can just kind of have a more organized outlook of all the assignments for the week. And then you have to do, which will tell you everything that's going to be due this week. It'll give you a whole entire list of things. And then you should have all your classes right here. So I'm going to click on my sociology class. Right here on the stream, you're going to have all your assignments that they've given you for the week or previous weeks. Over here on the classwork, it'll give you any classwork that has already been turned in or that you need to turn in. And over here on people, you have all your classmates that are in the class that you can message personally if you have any questions or need any help.
Warriors, do you want to remember this?
Students, if you have been checking your email, teachers are trying this Google Meet as a way to teach or answer questions. You can get Google Meet on your laptop or your phone. To download on your phone, go to Apple Store, type in Meet, click download, and wait. After downloading, it will give you a couple questions. And then sign in with your school email. And there you are, you're ready to learn. And just remember, Google Meet is a learning opportunity. You should not be distracting. Listen and pay attention, as your teachers are willing to help. Thank you.
This communication right here is what everybody needs to see for everybody in Northwestern District. So they're really trying to hit that hard, trying to keep people's spirits up.
Here's some Google Meet etiquette.
Yo, Mom, what's for dinner? Okay.
Expectations versus realities of quarantine.
Oh, I have so much time. Whew. My kids are gonna get their work in. They're gonna do an amazing job. Gosh, I'll answer all my emails on time. It's just, it's gonna be pretty good. Everything will stay organized. It's gonna be great. It's gonna be great.
Coffee. I need coffee.
Man, I have been looking around. I cannot find Josh's work, or Timmy's work, or Latricia's work. Where is their work?
This is the 1001st email I've gotten in the past 5 minutes. Easter Sunday. I get to relax with family.
Who sent me an email?
Man, I can't wait to go outside today. I heard it's like 70 degrees. It's warm.
It's almost like Florida.
It's kind of cold. This is not what I was expecting. Why is it windy? Why? I'm going back inside.
Man, I got everything ready to go. I got my books, my binders, everything's organized. I'm so ready for this week.
My teachers gave me all of my work on Sunday evening. I did it all on Monday, so I have the rest of the week to play and do whatever I want. This is gonna be great.
I have all the motivation to get all of this done, man.
This is the only food I've had in 2 days. Get out of my room. It's like 2 p.m. It's too early for this.
Here's some stuff to make at home.
I don't wanna fall asleep, I don't wanna pass away. I've been thinking.
Story time with Mr. Beals.
Good evening, Warrior Nation. It's Easter Sunday evening, and I'm sitting out on my back deck enjoying one of the things that I enjoy most is to sit out here and watch the rain fall. I find it very peaceful. But it also reminded me of a saying that I wanted to share with you this week, and that is, April showers bring May flowers. Or in translation, a period of adversity or discomfort is followed by a period of happiness and good fortune.
We certainly have encountered adversity in April with the spread of the coronavirus, and I do not want to diminish the economic and public health despair we are encountering, or the devastation of school closures. However, I choose to focus on positivity and encourage you to do the same. This month, I've seen a lot of love, caring, and serving. People helping neighbors, family, and friends. I've also seen a lot of people focusing on their physical fitness. We are warriors strong. Choose positivity and kindness each and every day, and watch the seeds of positivity and kindness grow all around you.
Spring Fling is on. Here's the information.
Hello, Northwestern. Luke Macy here with some exciting news. For those of you who were disappointed that Spring Fever would not be able to go on with the lockdown this year, we're coming to the rescue. We are planning to put together a Spring Fever video that will show May 1st. We encourage all high school students with a talent and passion for entertainment to send in a video. Videos must be school appropriate. Any videos that are not school appropriate will not be accepted. Please send them in to my email address, macy.luke@nwlschools.org, no later than April 26th. If you have any questions, contact Mrs. Bogus, Mrs. Perks, or myself. There is no better time to keep positive with entertainment than now. Stay safe, warriors.
A day in quarantine.
What's up, Warriors? I haven't been with you guys for a long time, and I miss you guys. And it's been a rough time. And to top it all off, it's pretty cold outside. So while we're stuck at home, we can't even be doing outside activities. So there's not really much to do. Mostly I just lay in bed, you know, do schoolwork a little bit. I try to get outside as much as I can, but today it's pretty cold. It's supposed to be cold all week. But I just wanted to say, stay strong, and I miss you guys, and I hope to be back this year. And stay safe, and stay inside, listen to your parents and the governor, because they're just trying to keep you safe. outside before I catch something. I'll see you guys soon.
This is Lucy. Remember the warrior way. Be kind, respectful, and responsible. See you soon, warriors.
Weekends are for the warriors. All those late nights walking through front doors at daybreak.